think I'll be able to do the shifter like this. Oh, no, no. Oh, God.
So, finally getting to some much-needed maintenance. Getting rid of the kickstand kill switch. Hit a jump the other day and it kind of bottomed out and died on me. Almost threw me over the handlebars. You work on these when you come back from a sport bike background like I did. I had a couple CBRs you want to make sure you take your fairings off. You take care of them so you don't scratch them. Make sure they're all out of the way. Now make sure all your fairings are securely fastened when you put them back on your bike so they don't go flapping in the wind. Because you hate to have stuff flapping on your bike when you're out riding it around.
This is the kickstand kill switch when the bike is in gear and the kickstand's down. This switch will kill the bike, which is a good thing if you're like being stupid. You go to like, oh, I'm going to take off, click, and this is down, stalls the bike. What sucks on dual sports and supermotos is if you jump the bike, the kickstand will pop slightly, and this will kill your engine. So this is pretty simple to remove right here. It's more than just removing it, though, but I'm going to show what we have to do to sort of trick the engine into always thinking that the kickstand is up. We're going to take this cable here, and we're going to follow this cable on up.
Into this fucking clusterfuck somewhere. I think we found it. Yeah, that should be it right there. Alright. And where's the dykes?
The dykes.
There they are.
Probably at the fucking Blue Oyster.
To cut this fucker about here right now. This doesn't matter. This is never going back on because it's stupid.
Is that shit? That's the precise measurement?
That's the precise measurement. Fuck it. I don't know. That thing sucks and you're never going to reuse it. Take about this much of it right here and we're going to take it over and all this, just fucking throw it away and never use it again. Put this hardware in your toolbox because that's where you get bolts from that you just used like a minute ago.
We still got some shrink wrap up here too, don't we? I wonder if these are all kind of big though, aren't they?
And again, I'm just doing this professionally here to look all good. On every deer Z I do off camera, I just twist these two together and put tape around it. But this is the interweb, so we gotta fucking try to make it look like we know what we're doing.
Well, you know you're blowing everyone's mind right now, like, because everyone thought you died at the end of the first video. And then the second video, they're like, oh my god, Jake, did he die? And now it's fucking...
Hey, I just blew what was left of the AC out. And you saw me, you were with me the next day. I was in fucking pain. And then it went away. I was like, oh, this hurts so bad. And then it just stopped hurting.
Ooh, what you say?
That clump of shit. Spread that out a little bit.
Professional. Always use the right tool for the
job. Always use the right tool, yeah, mate. Shut up. This is really fucking hot.
You know, everyone's gonna be talking. She's like, if it wasn't Jake, they could have just grabbed it with their hands.
Well, they're not here, so fucking let's see whatever they want. Yeah, I have a feeling this won't shrink quite enough, but whatever. Fucking put electrical tape over it if I'm wrong. Are you gonna. Oh, you do it.
Can I do it one handed?
Oh, you. No! You fucked it up.
It's because I was doing it left handed.
No, that's your excuse. I do everything left handed.
Except for the stranger.
Yeah, because I'm, you never use your dominant hand for that. You have a feeling this isn't going to quite shrink enough. I don't know.
Definitely need a stand for this.
What, for the camera?
Yeah.
Well, that's the thing. I keep using my phone to record everything because, unfortunately, it's like the best fucking camera I've got right now. Isn't that great? You know?
Yeah, I mean, what if the GoPro's audio wasn't shit?
Even that records better than my GoPro does. That goes 4K and at more frames per second. Now, if it was the newest GoPro, that'd be a different story, but...
How do you get a new GoPro?
Buy a shirt!
Watch that Canon pain's frightened by the time I put this up. Alright, whatever. It's a little bit fuckety, but... It's not fuckety. Fuck it, that looks great. I don't care. No... Again, like I said before when we did the tail light, we try not to modify the wiring, the true wiring harness. Modify shit before it. This has just got to plug back in some way, and hopefully you're smarter than I am, and you know which way it goes. It's that way. And then that just stuff down in there. And that's that. I mean, now
you can start it.
And then if you put it kickstands down, come over here. Now we can do that. So
the only thing when you do this is you got to be a little bit smart in your brain. I mean, on my gear, you've got your clutch. Is your clutch
kickstands down, bikes in gear. I'm not pulling the clutch in. I'm going to hold the brake as I do this. Yeah, so it's just, you got to be careful if you're going to do this, but now you can jump the bike without stalling it.
You have to know how to motorcycle.
Yeah, it's like a trigger safety, like this kind of safety, you know, it takes a little bit of something up.
Let's
there.
Let's fire it up real quick. I want to see what the taillight looks like. Maybe there's more voltage going to it. It's a little bit brighter.
Oh, with it running?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a special one. You got to...
Of course.
All right. Well, that's that. Your bike's got oil, tail light, and kickstand switch.
Fuck removed. Yeah. Buy Thumper Talk Case Savers.
You could technically use this as a full throttle nitrous switch for your car. When the pedal goes down, it'll shut it off. So you could keep this if you really want. And you got a little piece of wiring right here that's perfectly fine. I've got so many secondary air systems in here. You still filming?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, look at these. These motherfucking things. I probably got like 30 of these in a box somewhere. These fucking... make the bike clean kind of shit, I don't know.
Clutch handle.
I just fucking take them off, I hate that shit.
Oh yeah.
What are you gonna use?
I don't know. Most of this shit I didn't buy. It like came from something I was working on. It was leftover parts, and then I kept them, and then...
So what you're saying is when you work on bikes, you have leftover parts?
Yeah. You want a frame slider?
Ooh.
A single? I only have one, so you can only drop your bike on one side.
I don't know.
I don't know, dude. I don't know where half that shit came from, but whatever. All right. Well, hope you learned something today, people.
That's the best noise. All right, what's the next one we got to do? There it is.
Fucking drowning it in the bathtub right now.
Well, yeah, we're all over here.
Fucking dog, and it's over there.